Hello everyone, in the previous video we installed and set up a basic NextCloud server. In this video, I'll show you how to install a free SSL certificate with Let's Encrypt for your NextCloud server, so that your connection is always encrypted and secure. First, make sure you already have a NextCloud server running stably. If not, you can check out the previous video or the link in the description below. Next, let's go through this diagram a little bit. End case 1. NextCloud is installed on a VPS or cloud server. In this setup, the domain points directly to the server on the internet, so you don't need to manually configure port access. Ports 80 and 443 are usually open by default. Case 2. NextCloud is installed on a local server within a private network. Here, the domain still points to your public IP, but to make it accessible from the outside, you need to configure your router or firewall to open ports 80 and 443, and then forward them to the IP of your local server. This is a required step for Let's Encrypt to verify your domain and issue the SSL certificate successfully. In my case, the NextCloud server falls under case 2, meaning it's installed on a local server. Therefore, the next step is to open the necessary ports on the firewall or router. First, log in to the administration interface of your router or firewall. Next, depending on the type of modem or router you are using, the interface may look different. In general, look for a section named NAT, port forwarding, or sometimes just forwarding. Here, create two new rules to open port 80 and port 443. Then, configure port forwarding so that these ports are directed to the internal IP address of your NextCloud server. Make sure that this internal IP address is static or reserved via DHCP to avoid situations where the IP changes and the configured rules no longer work. Alright, so we've completed the port configuration for NextCloud. Now let's move on to the next step, pointing your domain to the public IP address of your server. In your domain's DNS management panel, create an A record pointing to the public IP address of your NextCloud server. To find your public IP address, you can quickly check it on WhatDisme IP. I'll leave the link in the description. Alright, so we've successfully created a subdomain for NextCloud. Next, open the terminal on your server. In this step, we need to make some adjustments to the virtual host configuration file of NextCloud to ensure that the newly created domain is properly mapped to the NextCloud application. This is the virtual host configuration file that we created in the previous video. Now edit the server name directive and replace it with the subdomain you just created for NextCloud. Once you've made the change, save and exit the file to apply the configuration. Next, restart the Apache server to apply the changes you just made in the virtual host configuration. Also, make sure that Apache is running properly after the changes. If Apache is running, you'll see the status displayed as active. All right, everything is ready. Now let's install Certbot to obtain an SSL certificate. First, update your system with Next, install Certbot and its required components for Apache. Once Certbot and the Apache plugin are installed, The next step is to run certbot to issue an SSL certificate for your domain. At this step, enter your email address so certbot can use it to send notifications about your certificate status as well as reminders before it expires. Next, type yes to accept Let's Encrypt's terms of service. Next, type yes or no to indicate whether you want to share your email address with the EFF. If you see the message, congratulations, your certificate and chain have been saved successfully. Congratulations, the SSL installation for NextCloud was successful. Next, restart Apache to make sure all the new SSL configurations are fully applied. Now, you can access NextCloud via HTTPS using the domain you configured. When you open it in your browser, you should see the secure padlock icon, confirming that the connection is encrypted and secure. That's it! We've successfully installed a free SSL certificate from Let's Encrypt for NextCloud. I hope you found this video helpful. Don't forget to like and subscribe for more tutorials. Thank you for watching.